Hi, I'm Lauren Admire, and this is the video supplement to my 5 favorite games of 2009. Brutal Legend is the perfect game for metalheads. It's got metal music, metal outfits, and even star appearances from famous metalheads of yore, such as Ozzy Osbourne. Unfortunately, I'm not a metalhead, so I mostly play the game for the Deuce. The Deuce is an upgradable tank of a car, which you can use to roll along the countryside, rocking out and causing mayhem. The game world is huge, and for now I've abandoned the main mission quest just so I can drive around in the Deuce exploring. Just don't hit the poor animals. They can't help it that they're deformed freaks of nature. I've been a fan of the Sims franchise since the original games came out. At this point, whenever a new iteration or expansion pack is released, I feel compelled to buy it, like some sort of addict who needs their hit of endless victimization of Sims created to look like her enemies. Or, you know, something like that. The Sims 3 took everything I hated about The Sims 2 and cuts it all out. No more long transition screens between neighborhoods, no more tapping my fingers, waiting for my Sims to return from work or school, and, best of all, no more static families that remain forever young while my own Sims age and die like so many withering flowers. I'm a huge fan of mindless games you can play while watching catty reality TV shows. It's just one of my things. No game has ever been so mindless yet so addicting as Diner Dash and all the other dashes that have come after it. From planning weddings to managing diners and pampering wayward children and pets, I've followed flow from one career to another. This time, it's hotels. Guests check into the hotel, you bring them their bags, extra towels, and room service, then you clean up after them and send them on their merry way. It doesn't get much more complicated than that, but that's just fine with me. After all, I don't want to miss the part in Bad Girls Club where they get into a catty girl fight over shoes. While waiting for World of Warcraft Cataclysm to come out, Ion is what I play. It's your standard MMOG, which is just fine with me. After all, if there's one thing I know how to do, it's grind levels. In WoW, I've got the grind down to a science, which is usually abandoned in the Barrens. But Ion takes the soul-weary grind and makes it interesting again. Through cutscenes and choosing a new path at level 10, Ion makes you feel like you're actually an essential part of the game and not just another hero to be helping Manric find his wife for the 1,000th time. I love this about Ion. Plus, flying is really, really fun. Really. By now, I'm sure you've heard all about how Dragon Age Origins is the best new RPG out there, and it's true. If you're a big fan of aesthetics, you should definitely play this game on the PC. Ferelden is a beautiful world, and playing it on a console is, frankly, a travesty. The rich storyline is compelling, and the myriad of dialogue choices available to your character really make you feel like your choices actually matter. I generally get bored in RPGs about halfway through just because the dialogue choices are so boring. Choose this if you're evil, choose this if you're good. These binary choices shoehorn your character into becoming either a saint or a demon. Dragon Age offers more choices which are more realistic and have actual consequences associated with them. Whatever choices you make, just be ready to while away hours and hours of your life to this game, possibly months.
As my body decayed, I found ways to extend it. But that can only go so far.
And those are my 5 favorite games of 2009. Happy holidays!